At the outset, I would like to congratulate Dr. Ranjana Kumari not for organizing this meeting alone, but for producing a wonderful book. And I always respect Dr. Ranjana Kumari. She is one of the outstanding human leaders in the contemporary India. And I have been watching her writings, her campaigns, her struggles. And today she has come out with a valuable book. I am just glad to. It should be one of the valuable additions to our knowledge. So I take this opportunity to congratulate Dr. Ranjana Kumari. You have heard a number of speeches before me. I have nothing to add, but I would like to reiterate the stand of CPI, for that matter, the entire left. And it is our cause. It is not only the cause of Dr. Ranjana Kumari or you, it is our cause to give the due space, equal space for our women in our political domain. Gender equality is an inherent, integral part of communist philosophy, communist ideology, communist politics. Perhaps you must be knowing this. Even way back in 1848, when the Communist Manifesto was produced by Karl Marx and Engels, gender equality was one of the fundamental issues which Marx and Engels brought up and spoke. So no civilization is civilization unless gender equality is acknowledged and established. What they claim, Indian civilization is one of the glorious civilizations in the world. Unless we acknowledge the due place, due space for women in our political domain, then our civilization cannot be called as a glorious civilization. This is my fundamental position. It applies to any country. No civilization can be termed as a glorious civilization or a genuine civilization unless gender equality is established. Coming back to the question of reservation to women, it is an issue on which the whole country has been agitating. Not only women, even men are agitating. It is not only cause of women, it is cause of men also. We are also agitating how to provide the fair share to women in policy making, in legislature, in parliament, all these forums. In fact, Comrade Geeta Mukherjee, she was one of the veteran parliamentarians. She is no more, and she became symbol of one third reservation to women. She fought, 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 and now she is no more. When the Rajya Sabha passed the bill to provide 33% reservation to women, I did participate in the discussion. I made an appeal to all political parties. Let us agree, because reforming the society is not an easy job. Dr. Ambedkar tried his best. Dr. Ambedkar had to resign as Law Minister when he wanted to amend the Hindu Court Bill, which was not accepted. With an anger and agony, Dr. Ambedkar resigned. And that time even Prime Minister could not hear. Then we said, now the Prime Minister has the support of the entire House. Prime Minister should take the bill from Rajya Sabha to Lok Sabha. You are talking about what is the distance between Janta Pandha to Parliament or India Gate to Rashtrapati Bhavan. What is the distance from Rajya Sabha to Lok Sabha?